Hello, Ray, Phoenix here again, and this time playing Star Wars Mysteries of the Sith, the demo version on the PC. You know, our economy has been going through some pretty tough times lately, especially where stocks are going, and, you know, the government's treat businesses and things like that, but there's so much taxes, so much inflation and things like that as well. It's hard to make a good living in today's world. I agree, I'll say, this sucks. Why don't I talk about Star Wars? Yeah, so I'll talk about Star Wars instead. Yeah, this is Star Wars Mysteries of the Sith. I believe there's an expansion on Star Wars Jedi Knight 2. Sorry, Star Wars Jedi Knight Dark Forces 2. This is all I ever had of this game. I never had the full game, so I just played this demo version. I've played this several times over, so I know it pretty well. You play as Kyle Katarn in this game, and as you can see, he has an orange lightsaber. Probably my favorite color for a lightsaber, actually, an orange lightsaber. I wish more Jedi had orange lightsabers. I don't know why. Supposedly, lightsaber colors have a certain meaning behind them. If you're a Star Wars nut and you're watching this video, can you please tell me what different lightsaber colors mean? That would be most appreciated. Thank you. Some kind of speedrunning through this demo. I'm flying through it, trying to get what I am. Need a dream. There's stormtroopers there that have weird packs on their backs, and they have machine guns. It turns you saw them have machine guns, they have other weapons too. I believe this is after Return of the Jedi, so they have, you know, so it's well, after the technology's advanced and it's in the future. It's like sneaking up on them, not when saw me, like sneaking up on these scout trooper guys, and they used on Endor and just slicing them down like that. So yeah, this game is very fun. I think this game is quite enjoyable. I'm playing it on a keyboard and mouse, and I'm recording at the same time too, so it's kind of difficult. But hey, I'm surprised, considering the age of this game's from 1998, I'm surprised this game works on my Alienware laptop. Yeah, that's right, I have an Alienware laptop. It's not that great, to be honest. It's not that great of a laptop, to be honest. But if you're into gaming, just get a regular Dell laptop. Those ones are better. Or even Asus laptop or something like that. Those ones are better than the Alienware. It also doesn't have a disk drive too, which kind of sucks. I know most people don't care about those anymore, but I still care about those. As well, it also doesn't have as many USB ports. So right now I'm trying to run away from... just trying to run away from the stormtroopers that are coming out through the space. These all seem to be after Kyle Katarn. But I'm good at running away. I mean, I've been playing Pac-Man my whole life. I know how to run away from people in video games. It's second nature to run away from people in video games and get weapons to use against them as well. Like in, I don't know, I can't think of any good games right now. I used to have weapons to use against them. Like in, yeah. So obviously I'm running fast again. I almost got blasted there again, right? I did get blasted, get singed, get pushed around. And look at them. Those two guys are kissing each other from the looks of it. I never realized the Empire allowed couples to work in their as stormtroopers or scout troopers. See, I got that one down too, and then he could slash through there and collect some stuff. So yeah, I think the graphics in this game are decent, considering the fact this game was made in 1998. And also, I am impressed it works my Alienware laptop well. I've played indie games from that same time. It probably looked just as good as this, visually looked as good as this. And there's a generator. Turn it on. Turn the power back on. I swear, my superintendent sometimes shuts down my electricity purposely to inconvenience me and scared me a lot. But I got back on the superintendent. What I did was I went over to their apartment, the superintendent's apartment, at 3 a.m. and I took out my loudspeaker and I blasted the EAS tone. You know, the EAS tone, the emergency alert system tone they play on TV, radio, and everything. Yeah, I blasted that at them. It's funny, I love drafting that tone at people to annoy people. If you don't know what the EAS emergency alert system tone sounds like, look it up if you don't know. And I should also make one, I should have used one that had, how they could make a, like a tornado warning or something like that, or some civil emergency warning, or a nuclear attack warning. You know, there's nuclear attack warnings that come around, like in Hawaii sometime ago, or the zombie one, the one where the guy made the fake zombie interruption one, that one was pretty funny. Unless you're those people in Montana that are that gullible and actually believed it was real, and they take out their shotguns or their rail chargers, which I'm using the game right now to take out an AT-ST. I wonder when they'll make a Star Wars zombie movie. Still, Disney's all big on making so many different Star Wars movies and things like that. I wonder when they're going to make a Star Wars zombie movie. It only makes sense they would. I mean, with Walking Dead being popular, or was popular, or... yeah. They should. They really should. They probably will make. There probably will be a Star Wars everything eventually. Star Wars, like, Star Wars Western, Star Wars Mythology, Star Wars, Star Wars Archaeology. I don't know. I can't really think of anything right now, but you get my point. So now this part's kind of impossible. I don't know how to get through this without taking a hit. You have to run through his fan blades. At least they're not like Spider-Man. Spider-Man got his head cut off in a fan. Yeah, Spider-Man could go through that. You should just get Spider-Man to do stuff in this game. And I believe the demo is just about over. Yep, the demo is over. This is Ray Phoenix signing out again.